What's happening, Hypesters? Welcome back to part 5 of making a game in HypeHype. In the last video, we started to take a look at logic by creating this goal area. This time, we're going to continue working with logic by getting into containers, reusables, and behaviors. Now, if you're a little confused by that last one, behaviors were previously called add-ons. Even in the last video we made, they were still called add-ons. This is a very recent change. So in the end of the last session, we collected all the logic we had created into a container by selecting all the nodes and tapping this plus icon. Of course, then we had to name our container. We could also add a container from the logic menu and just manually drag our nodes into it. And again, there we go, container. Again, we're gonna wanna name this container. Containers are a great way to keep your logic tidy and, like I just mentioned, keep it organized, let you know how everything works, but containers are also how we make reusables and behaviors. So what is a reusable and why do I wanna use them? So reusables are objects often with some logic applied to them that can be repeated throughout your hype. And the big advantage to using reusables is that any edits that are made to the original container will be applied to any instance you've created of that reusable throughout your hype. So let's demonstrate. Let's say we want to have multiple of these goal areas in our hype. We can turn this goal area into a reusable. First thing we need to do is grab our object there and add that into the container. And then we'll go to our container, and in the type, we'll change that to reusable. It's also possible to create a reusable directly from selected objects and nodes. So again, we've taken everything out of the container here. We're gonna select our goal area, we're gonna select our three nodes, and then we'll hit the actions menu, and down at the bottom here, we're going to add to builder panel. Again, we need to give it a name. By default, it's given us the name of our particle effect, but that's not what we want. We want it to be a goal area. Now, regardless of which way you create your reusable, once you have it, it will appear in the builder panel. We can see here under reusables, we now have the goal area right here. And the original object that we had in the game world remains in the world as an instance of that reusable. So this here is no longer the original circular marquee that we created, it's a new one that has been created from the contents of that container. If we want to add more, we can just tap the goal area in the builder panel there and tap on the screen where we want to add a container, or we can drag from the builder panel into our game world. So now we have multiple instances of our goal area, and any one of them is going to trigger our game end. So now that we have a few instances in our world, let's see what happens when we edit the container. To edit the reusable container, we're going to go to the builder panel, tap on the reusable, and that tap edit. This will expose the container in the game world, and now we can make some edits to it. Let's say, for example, I changed my mind. I don't want this circular marquee. I'd rather have a square one. So I'm going to search marquee. I'm going to change the item there. And then when I go look at the rest of my goal areas, we can see they're now all square. If we test that, there they go, all square. But now that they're square, that little spinny animation, that's not really working for this. So let's go in here. We have the simple animation. In case I want to turn it back on later, I'm just going to disable it for now. But if we know for sure we don't need it, we could just delete that node entirely. Now our square marquees are just nice static squares, any one of which can trigger our game end. So that's a reusable. Now, what's a behavior? Behaviors are going to be very similar. The main difference is that behaviors are applied to objects instead of having the object and everything else self-contained within one container. We have a few behaviors in here already that are associated with our player controls. And if we want to take a look at those, again, we can hit edit and it'll find us the container in the game world. Now, this is a player control container, so it's got a lot going on in here. Don't get overwhelmed. This is some pretty advanced stuff. It's okay if what you're working on is much simpler than this. The main reason I wanted to show this is to point out that within the behavior, there's always going to be a reference object. This object, you're never going to see. It acts as a stand-in for the object that you're going to apply this behavior to. So you can see in here, a lot of these nodes have signals going in and out of that object. The object itself might even have some nodes within it. In this case, just a couple simple ones: character animation, physical visual. So just like with reusables, we can drag behaviors into the world from the builder panel. The main difference here is that we need an object to apply them to. So we could take this player control and apply it to our character. Of course, this character already had player controls, but I took it away just to demonstrate. And now when we go in here, we can see player control there. It's at the bottom now because it's been added last, but it should still work if we go in and play. And of course, we could add that to any, in this case, we would want it to be a player model, the humanoid player model. We could add it to any player model that we wanted, and that player model would then have player controls. We could add the other ones, the health system, the turn camera system, the jump indicator if we wanted it. So let's say we want to make a destructible platform. I've already created a simple logic setup here. We have an object that is our reference object standing in for our platform. It has a collision trigger in it, again, looking for that green group. And that collision trigger sets off a number of logic nodes here that will make the object flash for a little while and then destroy after 1 second. So just like we did with the reusable, I'm going to select everything we have here and I'm going to add it to the builder panel. We're going to call this destructible object. Now, again, it's left an instance of this puzzle piece because it did not turn that into a behavior right away. It's turned it into a reusable. So again, I'm going to go edit this. I'm going to go into the container details, and from reusable, I'm going to change that to behavior. We do now get a warning here that says that that one instance that it created is going to go away because behaviors do not have instances, and that's fine. So we're going to hit OK. And now our destructible object is a behavior. And we can take that and apply it to any object, like this cube here. So now we got the cube. When I touch it, it's going to flash, and then it's going to destroy. And I realize in my logic there, let's edit this. I forgot to loop this, so it wasn't flashing right. Now let's try it again. There we go, flashes, and then it goes away. Obviously, some particle effects, something there might be nice. You know, as we develop our game, maybe we're going to want to adjust how long it takes before the thing destroys, that kind of thing. But the basic thing is there, and we can apply that to any object we want. So now that we know a little bit more about reusables and behaviors, let's go back to premades, because premades are usually going to be either a reusable or an object with some behaviors attached to it. There's a lot of different premades we could use for this type of game. Let's say, for our sake, we want some collectibles. So I'm going to search collect there. We got keys, we got gems, we got coins. We've even got collectibles that will take score away from you if that's something that you want. I'm just going to go for the simple coin for right now. Now, this is a reusable, so when it added into the game world, it added the container, but it also gave us one instance of that reusable. If I play test here, we can see I can go and collect that coin. And of course, now we can add as many as we want from the builder panel here. Now, all the premades are designed to work together, so these coins, as we just saw in the last play test, are going to automatically work with our player character. Boom. Now, of course, any good obstacle course is also going to have some hazards. So let's look for any hazard reusables. I'll just search hazard. And we can see we got a whole mess of them there. I'm just going to take these simple spikes here. We got simple spikes. Again, it's created one instance for us already. We can drag more from the builder panel. We can tap to add more. And with these instances, we can even copy paste. And again, just like the coins, these are going to work automatically with our guy. You see he touches the spikes, he takes some damage. Now, as we looked at before with premades, there might be a few settings in here that we can quickly edit. Here we've got the score amount, we've got animation settings, some basic settings of this coin. One thing to note about these settings in the basic details panel is that these will only affect the instance that you have selected. This is not going to change all of the instances like editing the container does. And if you go into the advanced details, it's possible that making changes here will affect others. And when you do that, it'll give you a warning on those nodes, modifying reusable source. This lets you know that if you change this, it's going to change for all of those For example, if we change this from red instead of green, now all those coins are only going to interact with objects in the red group, and our guy's not going to be able to collect them, but of course we don't want to do that. Okay, so those are some simple edits we can make directly within the instances of this reusable, but maybe we want to make some changes to affect everything. And if we want to make deeper changes to a reusable, we're going to want to do that in the container. So again, for premades, we're going to want to find that container. We're going to hit it in the builder panel and hit edit. And now sometimes because these were added from the asset library, you might need to move the container into a position where it's going to be easier to work with. Of course, as we've done before, we can really easily just change the visual model here. Let's say instead of these spikes, I want these thorny vines. This one right here. Now we've got a thorny vine instead of spikes. And again, we go over here, we can see all of our spikes have become thorny vines. So we can edit any of our premades just as easily. We can make changes to the logic as well. It's not just changing visuals. You can change anything in this container you want, and it's going to affect all of the instances you have in the world. Now, for more complex things, it might be a little more difficult when you go into the container to figure out what everything does. And so this is where getting a little more comfortable with the different nodes and how they work is going to really be helpful. But let's just say, for example, we want to change the jump animation of the player character. And then just for reference, my guy's getting hurt. This is what my jump animation looks like right now. We want to change this one. So first thing we're going to do is go to the asset library and add a new jump animation. So we got a lot of different jumps here. I kind of like this athletic jump. It's got a nice action-y pose with the arms sticking out and the legs tucked in. It's a nice jump animation. I'm a fan. Now, when you add any new animation into the scene, it is going to come with a model. For now, I'm going to leave that there. I'm just going to turn it invisible so that we don't see it. It doesn't affect anything. We can already see it doesn't have any physical properties. So that essentially gets it out of our way for now. So next we're going to need to find our player controls. So we'll go to our behaviors, and again, we're going to hit edit on those player controls. We've got a big mess here that we looked at earlier. And like I said, this is where kind of knowing how things work is really going to be helpful. Luckily for me, I already know a little bit about how this player control works. And I know that this 2-4 decoder named states is where the magic happens. So when we open this up, we can see two outputs here that have a jump animation. We have jump pose from both off, and we have jump pose from value A on. And all we're going to do is really simply go in here. We're going to change that jump pose to our jump athletic pose. Boom. And now we've changed the jump animation. You can see we get the, not if I hit the finish line, but you can see we get that nice arms out, legs tucked in. Love this jump animation. Now, of course, there's a lot more we can do. You have your run poses. You have tons of other settings in here you could change if you wanted to tune how these player controls work. But for now, you get the basic idea. And that's going to be it for this lesson. Now that you know a little bit more about reusables and behaviors, I encourage you to play around with some of the premades, try and make some of your own, use them, get a feel for how they work. It's really going to help you out moving forward. In the next lesson, we're going to look at building out our game world. We'll take a look at a few more premades and logic nodes, and we're also going to look at tile sets, a nice, easy way to fill in space in your level. Thanks for joining me for this lesson. I look forward to seeing you next time. Now you can enjoy all the times I messed up making this video. Peace out, Hypesters. What's happening, Helpsters? Welcome back, Helpsters. The main reason I wanted to show this is to point out that the container, so that's a reusable. Now, why does it say add on there? It should say behavior. I don't have a keyboard. It's going to confuse me. Blah, blah, blah. And of course, now we can add as many as we want from the builder panel here. Coins. And if you do decide to make a change that if you go and if you do so, it'll give you the area.